Good afternoon, Pastor David.
Hey, John.
Welcome, everybody, to A Random Moment with Pastor David Unfiltered. Pastor, last Wednesday, you started a series on spiritual warfare.
Isn't that fun?
It's been warfare ever since. Ephesians chapter 6, and I'm looking forward to the study tomorrow because you're going to start looking at the weapons. Mm-hmm. But, you know, one of the things that's interesting is when you pointed out last week that when we think of spiritual warfare, sometimes we think it's this big dragon that we're fighting, or it's the big demon or a lion jumping out in front of us. And when reality, you know, it can be a number of things. It could be our flesh. It can be a number of different things. But you mentioned that it can be the smallest thing. And you were sharing that last week, that this battle that we have, this warfare that we go through, it's a wrestle. And that wrestle seems like it speaks of close hand-to-hand combat. And so our fight with the spiritual realm is not only just the big, big demons and stuff. It's the everyday battles that we go through that is a close quarters fighting.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so when we look at this, God, you spoke a little bit about the whole armor of God. It talks about when we put this armor on, the next thing we're to do is stand. How does that happen when we're in this wrestle, this close contact of this battle? We have this armor. You're going to be introducing the belt of truth, but yet we're to stand.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a girdle, something you'd be familiar with, John. The girdle of truth. Yeah, when Paul is speaking of that, like I was mentioning to the church, as we've been going through Ephesians, you know, it is broken into the three words, sit, walk, stand. And I was reminding our fellowship of the first three chapters being seated in Christ in heavenly places and the things that relates to. And then we go into the fourth chapter and we begin to speak of the walk of the believer, because the walk of the believer is always going to be built on foundationally by who we are. We're seated in Christ, you know. So knowing who we are prepares us to walk as those who know who we are in Christ, etc. But we also have warfare, and the warfare, sit, walk, stand. The warfare comes, you know, after being seated, after our walk, and then he reminds us of the fact that we're in a spiritual battle. So yeah, we war not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, you know, and the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God. So spiritual warfare requires, obviously, spiritual weapons. And so last week we looked at our enemy and the fact that he is a commander over his troops, if you will, the fallen angels who followed his lead and all. And so we began to look at the origin of the battle, and now we begin to see the weapons of our warfare. And so Paul begins in a way that he's enumerating the way that a soldier would actually dress or be prepared. And he began by girding his waist with a belt, a type of a belt, because he would wear a tunic and the tunic could trip him up. So he would lift the tunic and cinch it in his in what we call the girdle or the belt that he would wear. So that belt that he speaks of is the first thing the soldier would be adorning himself with, and it's truth. So we'll be looking at truth in sense of it as being it in terms of content, as well as in terms of its mental application. We'll be looking at that because we not only know truth, but we need to act on truth. And so we'll be looking at that because in the war, we need to understand that the weapon, the primary weapon that we have is an awareness that there is such a thing as truth. It's kind of like when Jesus was standing before the political governor, Pontius Pilate, who asked Jesus, "What is truth?" Mm-hmm. Well, that is still something that people are asking to this day. And because we have such an array of opinions as to what is truth, I'll be sharing a little bit about knowing the content of truth, which would be through our study and preparation through the Word of God, and our application of truth, which takes place when we're in spiritual warfare. Because even as Jesus was you know, confronted by the enemy, and Satan himself began to attempt to tempt our Savior. Jesus' response is what we're supposed to be responding. He said, "It is written, it is written, it is written." So his weapon of his warfare that he used to defeat Satan and said, "Get thee behind me," is the Word of God. So we'll be looking at what truth is a little bit tomorrow, why we can trust the Word of God, excuse me, and the application of it.
And, you know, one of the things that you mentioned, because people are even saying today, well, truth is relative, right? And I think being able to build that foundation of what true truth is vital to the rest of the pieces of the armor. But I like what you said, and I don't think you said it in your teaching, we said it in conversation, that oftentimes when we're going to get in a battle, we take time to study the enemy.
Oh, you study the enemy.
And this is where the belt of truth comes in, because in order for us to know our enemy, we must know God's word and be prepared, because I think it was you that mentioned that you knew somebody that day.
I have a friend of mine, yeah, who is a martial artist, and he said that he, before he would enter into any physical combat, he said, "I studied him." And the way he said it, it made sense to me. He was looking for his strengths and his weaknesses just by observing him. So the way he was standing, even the way that he posed himself, these were all insights into this friend of mine so that he'd know how to attack. And so being aware of our enemy, to know that, that he is like a roaring lion prowling and seeking whom he may devour. But Paul speaks concerning his devices and his strategies, his methods. And, so we have to be aware of the enemy. It's not that we admire, or it's not that we get caught up in. It's that we need to be aware that he uses a variety of things, the lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, pride of life. He uses various things, but he always seems to return to the same three core things that worked for him when he was there in the garden and presenting to Eve the original temptation. He still does that. There are only three basic areas that he usually strategizes and works on with us. And so we need to have truth. We have to be aware of what his devices are, and we need to withstand. Because Paul says stand, and then he says stand a second time, and then he says withstand. So stand, the first time he uses it, I believe in verse 13, it speaks of standing. It's a Greek word that means to stand with your feet planted, as a victor, somebody who's already overcome. So the mentality of the warrior is to know that we've already in Christ overcome. We're seated with him, we've walked with him, so we can stand and overcome. But there's another word that is used, the second time he uses the word stand, and that's more of a word that means to be braced and ready. You know, it's like a lineman on a football team who's braced, you know, for the onslaught that he's going to have when the person rushes. You know, you have to be ready for it. You need to handle that, these huge linemen and all of that. Well, they're prepared, they're braced for battle. And that's what Paul's talking about. It's the war is won. Christ won that war for us, and we know the end of our enemy because Revelation tells us he's cast into the lake of fire. So he's a defeated foe, but that doesn't mean the skirmishes don't continue. And so you have to be prepared and braced for it so that having done all, you stand. You can stand victorious. And we'll be looking at that tomorrow.
Look forward to this. I want to invite you guys to come out and join us tomorrow at 7 p.m. for our Wednesday night service. It's a time of worship and getting into God's word and a time of fellowship. So I want to invite you guys to come on out. It's going to be a good study. I look forward to it. And so just want to thank you guys for tuning in. Pastor, thank you for sharing a little bit about what you're going to be teaching on tomorrow. And again, church family, come on out and join us. It's going to be a great time. God bless you guys. Again, thank you, Pastor David, and we'll see you guys soon.